Games, movies, TV, comics. Let's get on with it, shall we?
Hello YouTube, this is a BDrew1111, gamertag BDrew93. Just a small video. Basically, a lot of the time, especially from older people like parents or well, just not, well, don't have to be older people, it could be anyone really, people who don't understand or don't know how to play games or anything like that. But basically, I just wanted to do a video on why I game, why I game. Because it was only last week I had my girlfriend's parents over for dinner and they stayed the night, and I waited till everyone went to bed and then I went downstairs on my Xbox. He came downstairs, the father now, and asked me, what are you doing? Blah blah blah. Oh, that rubbish, you're on those things, are you? That rubbish game. And I was just like, how is it rubbish? And he was like, oh, it's just a waste of time, isn't it? And I was just like, well, explain why. And he was like, oh, well, yeah. And I was like, yeah, exactly, that's what I thought, because you don't know how to play. And he was like, well, what's the point in it anyway? And I was like, well, here we go. I was like, as simple as this. Why does someone read a book? Why does someone listen to music? Why does someone watch a movie or watch a TV series? Read a comic? Why do people draw? Ultimately, in the end, it's all for the same reason. I mean, I don't see the difference in reading a book or playing a game. You read a book, if you're reading Lord of the Rings or playing a Lord of the Rings game or Skyrim or Far Cry 4 open world, it's just different. It's like you're not. Like a book, you have to use your imagination, you have to read and concentrate, and you paint a picture in your head. Whereas with gaming, you're playing it. You are playing it. Like one of the better games I can give as an example for this is Telltale Games, The Walking Dead, seasons 1 and 2. Brilliant games. If you haven't got them, you have to get them. They are unbelievable if you're a fan of the comic book of Walking Dead or the TV series. Because it is literally you. It is like you're playing the comic book. Every decision you make, every avenue, it can change the consequences of things, people dying, and the outcome. And it's just a brilliant, brilliant game. But it's just a perfect example of what I'm talking about. Like that for me is so much better than any book or any program. Any film, because you're doing it, you're interacting, you are losing yourself in this world. And I'm not taking anything away from people who like to read or paint or, but I just can't stand it when people look down on gamers. Like, why? What are you doing, wasting your time on there? But then no one would question someone sitting on the sofa reading a book. When do you ever hear someone go, oh, what are you doing reading those books again? Oh, why do you waste your time? It's never ever said, at least I've never witnessed it. But somebody picks up a controller, there's always someone making a comment. And it's just like, get over yourself. Gaming is huge. GTA 5 made more money in its first day of release than the film Skyfall made in a year. The gaming industry is massive. It's bigger than the music industry and the filming industry. So, all I have to say to people who still think gaming's a waste of time, or why do people game, or why do they waste their time on games, they just need to get over themselves. Because end of the day, it's here to stay. And I love games, always have, always will. And it's Christmas tomorrow, and I'm hoping I've got Assassin's Creed Unity, so that'll just be another one to add to my list. Getting lost in the French Revolution. Not only are you getting lost in an amazing, massive, huge world, and it's an amazing story, better than any book or film, but it's historical. It's based on the French Revolution, so you're learning as well. There's so many pluses to gaming. I can only say so much, really. I think I've summed it up. So yeah, thanks guys. That's all I have to say about why I game. Put in the comment section why you game. and your reasons. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. Merry Christmas, guys. Ta-ra. Hi, guys. Just in addition to you know, where I left off, because I forgot to say, another reason for me personally why gaming is so important to me. I mean, I've always gamed. It's not like this was the reason I started gaming. I've gamed as long as I can remember, but yeah, like for me, like a massive part of gaming for me was a couple of years ago. I mean, I was leaving school, secondary school, and I left my, you know, I left like before like my exams and stuff. I just couldn't hack it anymore. School life was rubbish for me. I didn't enjoy the last year or so of school. You know, I felt quite alone. I wasn't really getting along with my mates at that particular time. I don't know, it was just, without going too deep and, you know, glum, you know, it is Christmas tomorrow after all. But just, you know, I'm just saying, end of the day, like, everyone has their reasons to do things, and everyone has their release, and everyone has their hobbies, and you got to respect that, because for me, gaming, that was a huge part of, well, I was in a bad place. I was really depressed for a time. I was in a hole I thought I'd never get out of, and I honestly do believe, through Xbox Live and the community and online matchmaking, Gears of War community, Halo 3 community, it picked me up. Granted, it took a few months, like quite a few months actually, but I actually thank gaming for how I got out of my slump. And it truly was because of gaming. Like, I made friends through Xbox Live, and even friends that I actually went to school with but didn't really know. And yeah, and that is another huge reason why gaming is so important to me, because it really did help me get through a hard part in my life, a hard time of my life. So yeah, so no worries. Everything's cool now, and it is Christmas tomorrow, so everyone keep positive. I'm not looking for any sympathy. I'm just saying that, like, you know, there's so many good reasons. I've already relayed a bloody load out for you, but that was just another reason I had to give, but I forgot to say. So there you go, there you have it. So have a very, very Merry Christmas, guys, and yeah, take it easy, and I hope you get everything you wish for off Santa Claus. Nice one, guys. Ta-ra. Bye-bye.